Museo ni Jesse Robredo, Museo ni Jose Cesar Dapitan, Museo ng Kasaysayang Bucolano, Museo ni Juan at Antonio Luna, Museo sa Kasaysayang Pang-Ekonomiya ng Pilipinas. At kung may mga katanungan po kayo, ilagay lamang po sa aming comment section upang masagutan ang ating tagapagsalita. Upang formal na simulan ang ating programa ngayong hapon, pinapakilala ko po ang Shrine Curator 2 ng Museo ni Jesse Robredo, si Ginoong Mark Anthony Berberoso.
Maraming salamat, Joan. Isang mapagpalang araw po sa ating lahat. Muli po kami nagpapasalamat sa inyong pakikiisa sa mga online lecture na libreng inihahatid sa inyo ng Pambansang Komisyong Pangkasaysayan ng Pilipinas. Ang tema po ng online lecture natin ngayon ay ang makulay na kasaysayan ng Our Lady of Peñafrancia na tinatawag din ng mga taga-Naga na ina. So, tuwing buwan ng Setyembre ay nakasanay na ng mga Bicolano ang pagdiriwang ng kapistahan ng Peñafrancia. Sa panahong ito ay nagtutungo ang mga deboto ni Ina at maging pati na rin ang mga turista sa siyudad ng Naga upang saksihan ang makulay na tradisyon ng traslasyon at fluvial procession. Ngunit dahil sa bantan sa kalusugan na dala ng pandemyang kinakaharap natin sa ngayon, ay hindi na isagawa ang mga tradisyonal na gawaing ito. Dahil dito, naging layunin ng webinar na ito na magbigay ng additional karagdagang kaalaman patungkol sa kasaysayan ng Peñafrancia ng Divino Rostro at pati na rin ang gampanin ng mga voyador tuwing nagsasagawa ng traslasyon. So hindi ko na po patatagalin pa. Ang atin pong tagapagsalita ay nagtapos ng Bachelor of Secondary Education, Major in History sa University of Nueva Cáceres. Nagtapos din siya ng Masters of Arts in Education, Major in History sa Bicol University. Doctor of Education in Education Leadership and Management sa Bicol University din. At nagtapos din siya ng Doctor of Philosophy in Education Foundation sa Bicol University. Nagsimula ang kanyang pagtuturo bilang college professor sa Universidad de Santa Isabel noong 2005 at ilan sa mga subject na hinawakan niya ay World History, Socio-Anthropology, at Philippine History and Culture. Naging Vice President ng Council of Deans for Graduate Education at siya rin ay life member ng Philippine Association for Graduate Education. Noong 2007, isinulat niya ang isang akdang pangkasaysayan na pinamagatang The Voyadores of Naga City. Siya po ang kasalukuyang dean ng Graduate School ng Universidad de Santa Isabel. Malugod ko pong ipinakikilala sa inyo ang ating tagapagsalita, si Dr. Cesar San Jose.
Let me start by thanking all of you in participating in today's webinar entitled Ina de Peñafrancia, the Voyadores Journey with the Grand Patroness of Bicolandia. And thank you, Sir Mark Anthony, for that very kind introduction. To the officials of the National Historical Commission of the Philippines, headed by Dr. Rene R. Escalante, the chairman of the National Historical Commission, the Philippines, Sir Mark Anthony de Glorioso, Shrine Curator of the Museo ni Jesse Robredo, and his companion, Sister Lourdes L. Albis, Daughter of Charity, University President of the Universidad de Santa Isabel, my good friend, Dr. Randy P. Bacares, our dear participants in this webinar, ladies and gentlemen, marhay na hapon sa inyo po, gabos. Good afternoon. As we begin with this webinar, I would like to invite you to first pray with me the prayer to Our Lady of Peñafrancia. Turn to me thine eyes, O most loving Virgin of Peñafrancia, and have mercy on my soul that come to thee full of repentance. Protect my family, my relatives, friends, and benefactors. Intercede for your devotees, both the living and the dead, especially for those whom I am most obliged to help. Pray for me, console me, save me in my hours of peril and adversity and affliction. Above all, in the hour of my death, appear before your divine Son to help and defend me. Tell him that I am your devotee, that having complete trust in your protection, I kneel before your miraculous image to ask for your powerful intercession. Virgin of Peñafrancia, pray for me, help me, console me, and deliver me from all evil. Amen. Friends, I am very pleased to have been invited to speak in this webinar on the blessedness of Ina, Our Lady of Peñafrancia, and I am particularly honored to have been given this opportunity to share the following historical and I would even say divinely inspired thoughts on the grand patroness of Bicolandia. We'll have some a little overture, have unlocked some technical definition, words and meaning. When we're going to talk about Ina de Peñafrancia, a historical reminiscing, the ceremonial and symbolic regalia of a 300-year-old image of Our Lady of Peñafrancia, the Ina's sacred artifact, which is Manto, the Voyadores of Ina de Peñafrancia, and of course, we're going to have a glimpse of El Divino Rostro, the divine healing icon, and some words of concluding statement. So, setting the scene today's webinar on Ina de Peñafrancia, let us first unlock some familiar words. First, Ina. When you speak of Ina, this is a native term for a mother. In this milieu, the name Ina pertains to Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia. El Divino Rostro de Naga, the image of the Holy Face of Jesus, which usually accompanied the image of Ina during translation and fluvial processions, and can also be seen in the old shrine and old new Basilica of the Virgin. This sacred image is known to be miraculous, particularly on saving the province from epidemics. Translación, another term, is actually of Spanish origin, trasladar, meaning to transfer. Translación is a devotional and processional transfer of the images of Ina in Divino Rostro from Basilica, the home of miraculous images, to Cathedral, which is the seat of the Archbishop of Cáceres, for 9 days novenary masses. Fluvial procession refers to a solemn procession carrying the image of Peñafrancia. It is Ina's Voyadores river trip from the Naga Cathedral back to Peñafrancia Shrine to culminate the fiesta, which is usually done on the third Saturday of September. Voyadores, they are male devotees who pledge to carry the image of Ina safely during traslacion and fluvial processions from Basilica to Cathedral, and the image will stay there for 9 novenary days. On the 9th day, the image of Ina will be brought again by the Voyadores back to Basilica Minore. These men folks serve as human cordon to the holy image of Ina by interlocking their arms and forming human chain during traslacion and fluvial procession. Peñafrancia Fiesta or Peñafrancia celebration is a religious celebration honoring the feast day of Our Lady of Peñafrancia. The feast day is preceded by a novena, 9 days of prayer, in honor of the Virgin. The Peñafrancia celebration is focused on the festivity that begins on the third Saturday of September, when the image of the Virgin of Peñafrancia is carried by hundreds of male Voyadores from her shrine to Naga Cathedral, where the novena is held. On the last day, the image is returned to her shrine following the river route. Voya, or Vuga, is an act of carrying an image. In this context, it gives meaning to all male Voyadores carrying the image of Our Lady of Peñafrancia. Friends, Bicolanos are considered a nature-loving people, and at the same time, they are ardent and bold in terms of religiosity, and I would say holiness. With their indescribable devotion to Our Lady of Peñafrancia, a true and genuine manifestation of being a Marian devotees. This slice of devotional reality, which I will be sharing with you, will at least let you know how Ina di Peñafrancia came to be and how it had changed and touch the lives of the Bicolanos and all her devotees at large. And spiritual, we also will try our best to have the chance to discover and rediscover in us illustrious and mysterious accounts from Spain to Nueva Cáceres, now Naga City, Philippines, by reminiscing historical facts about Ina di Peñafrancia. As you notice in this slide, the photos show that Ina, Nuestra Señora di Peñafrancia, is a wooden statue of the Blessed Virgin Mary and claimed to be miraculous. And accordingly, the image of Ina is a 17 inches santol wood sculpture and is considered a priceless religious icon made in 1710. And the old Virgin di Peñafrancia image in Naga City is considered the oldest Marian image after the original Nuestra Señora di Peñafrancia in Salamanca, Spain was actually destroyed in a fire. And so at this point, we will try to unearth how this devotion came to be. Let me show you, let me now share to you the historical accounts on how the devotion to Ina di Peñafrancia came to be from Spain to Naga City, Philippines, which I will be presenting chronologically comprehensive yet concise, of course, to avoid boredom. And so the devotion can be traced back to the city of Paris, France, where the child was actually born on the 4th of September, 1401, to a wealthy and pious parents, Roland and Barbara. The child was christened Simone. This boy, despite his material affluence, had no inclination on material goods. In fact, when his parents died and he inherited all their property, yet he sold all his endowment and donated the proceeds to the church, the poor, and to charitable institutions, and joined in the Franciscan order as a lay brother. Simon was a very religious person and had a great love and special devotion to the Blessed Mother Mary. So that in 1429, while Simon was in prayer, he actually lost his consciousness, yet heard a voice telling him, "Simon, be vigilant, wake up, be on the watch." And the Blessed Virgin accordingly instructed Simon to go to Peñafrancia and look for an image of the lady. Simon reached San Martin de Castañar in May 14, 1434. He went to church, and after the mass, he asked a man to kindly indicate where Peñafrancia was. The man took Simon's villa to a place some distance from the church and pointed to him a hill in far distance, saying that the hill was the Peñafrancia he was looking for. Simon was grateful and thanked God for having found a man who showed him the place of his dream. In the morning of 15th of May, 1434, on the spot where the apparition of the Holy Virgin disappeared, Simon began the work of digging and excavating with the help of Anton Fernandez, Pascual Perez, Benito Sanchez, Juan Hernandez, and Antonio Sanchez, the parish priest of the place. Finally, on May 19, 1434, after removing a huge stone, they found embedded among the rocks the most coveted image of the Holy Virgin with a child in her arms. Right there and then, all these men received special graces from the Virgin. And the official document of these miracles and this discovery, duly signed by those present in the notary public of the place, is actually kept in the archives of San Martin de Castañar. At this juncture, let me point out in this sharing how then the devotion to Peñafrancia came to the Philippines and or brought to Bicolandia in particular. In the 17th century, a Spanish family from San Martin de Castañar migrated to the Philippines and settled in Cavite. They had a son named Miguel Robles de Cabarrubias, who had, while studying for the priesthood in the University of Santo Tomas in Manila, was frequently ailing. He was actually sickly. And yet, providentially, he had an ardent devotion to Our Lady of Peñafrancia. And according to the account, though sakitin si Cabarrubias, he was actually healed when he touched the part of his body with the picture of Our Lady of Peñafrancia. Because of this, he made a promise to Our Lady that he would build a stone shrine on the bank of Pasig River in Manila. And he would also make a picture of Our Lady of Peñafrancia to be designed according to the model in the book. So that in 1710, Father Miguel began his construction of a small chapel to honor his promise to the Lady of the Peñafrancia in gratitude of the miracles the Virgin showed him from the grace of God. Father Miguel also ordered a statue of the Virgin replicating the estampita he always carries with him. It was painted with a pigment mixed with a dog's blood. The headless body of the dog was thrown in the river in a few minutes. The dog was witnessed swimming to the shore and running to his master's house was the start of the countless miracles that Our Lady of Peñafrancia would perform throughout the next 300 years. In 1864, due to growing devotees of Our Lady of Peñafrancia, the original shrine became too small to accommodate the devotees, the church, the Diocese of Nueva Cáceres, ordered that the image of Our Lady be transferred from the shrine to the cathedral to accommodate the devotees. So this became the first trasladar or traslación procession. In 1895, Pope Leo XIII declared that Our Lady of Peñafrancia be named as the patroness of the city of Nueva Cáceres, now Naga City. In May 2, 1920, the Vatican approved the canonical coronation of Our Lady of Peñafrancia by the edict of Pope Benedict XV. And in September 20, 1924, one of the joyous and momentous celebration was the solemn canonical coronation of Our Lady of Peñafrancia under the pontificate of Pope Pius XI. The Virgin of Peñafrancia is the second canonically crowned Marian image in the Philippines. One historian even remarked that the coronation of Peñafrancia in 1924, or Peña de Francia as it was called then, was the biggest historical event that Bicol has ever seen. In 1976, the construction of the Basilica Minore of Our Lady of Peñafrancia had been made. And in August 17, 1981, the image of Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia disappeared. It was stolen from its place in her shrine. It was August then, and the translation was days away na lang. It was indeed. So this was one of the painful occurrence in the Bicolano history when Ina was lost and sadly was stolen by nobody. It was a stormy day on September 8, 1981, when a motor crane from Manila brought back the Lady of Peñafrancia to Naga. As per record, it was written that as the car started to cross the bridge to Naga, the bell started to ring. People were out on the streets, unmindful of the storm, with their tears and exuberant joy. They had to meet the Blessed Mother coming home in September 8, 1982. My dear friends, this is a very significant, how do you call this, photo. This is actually the original image of Our Lady of Peñafrancia after being recovered. And it so happened that I was able to see this one with a very good friend of mine and asked permission to capture a photo. Ito po yung nangyari, ito yung itsura ng ina di Peñafrancia after it was recovered. No? Yung kanyang left eye, no? Yung kanyang left eye ay nawala, yung crystallized eyes. No? And if you would notice here, yung ninyo, yung sa parting right side, halos deteriorated na po yung mukha. Yeah. But it was actually restored later by a very good friend of mine, actually. Ayaw nang magpakilala. So, a very good friend of mine, as I have mentioned, whom I consider a legendary liturgical artist with whom the restoration of the image to be was entrusted by the local Spado, and it molded with the permission of the bishop then. And he had it perfectly formed. Ito po yung nakikita yung picture sa left. Ito po yung molded na, ano, na image ni Ina. Ito po yung exact na itura, original image of Ina. No? Kita niyo yung ano niya, pakakuha. And I want to take a closer look at the image of Ina. There you'll find a very picturesque details of her face. When I saw this, I actually fell in love with this image. Sabi ko, perfectly formed. No? Her eyes assuring her devotees, "Don't you worry, you are the apple of my eyes." Napaka-symbolic. Her eyelids, each of the upper and lower folds of skin which cover the eye. Nakikita niyo po ito na yung kanyang ano na parang may eye bag. And most of the time, hindi po ito nakukuha ng ibang sculpture or sculptor. Hindi nila perfect. Isan nga, unfortunate yung mata ng ginagawa nilang image, no? Delicate ito eh, nagpa-pop out. So yung itsura, parang iba naman, parang hindi ina di Peñafrancia ang itsura. No? Ito po yung original actually, na hulma, no? Ng mahal na ina de Peñafrancia. And try to notice also her lips, so thin and small. What do you think? This symbolizes silence, as the Blessed Mary would always be appearing, even in the Gospel, is full of silence. Her nose is straight and well-shaped. And notice also the forehead, spacious, yet proportioned. I told the, ano nga na, ito na yung from here, sa right side po, ito yung eksaktong kuha ng imahe, replica from the molded, how do you call this, image of the original ina. Ito po yung itsura. And you would notice the ninyo, yung ninyo po ay parang, ang itsura niya parang iiyak. No? Sa iba, ang nangyari ay nakasmile na yung ninyo. Ang original po, yung parang iiyak ang itsura ng ninyo. Parang nakikita niya na yung kanyang magiging kapalaran in the future. And yet, he is being assured and reassured by the Blessed Mother, I am with you, my son. Just like in our case. We always on this to mind this illustration. It seemed Ina Peñafrancia appeared to be a 60 years old woman. Itsura niya po ano, tingnan niyo. Very far from other images and icons of Mary, which most of the time depict a young lady on her 20s. And I was reflecting actually when I was preparing this presentation, according to some accounts even, Mary died physically, yet it was just momentarily, at about the age of 60 years old. So siguro itong ina ni Peñafrancia, na-capture niya yung no, itsura ng ni Maria na matanda na at the age of 60, died momentarily and yet assumed into heaven body and soul. Ito po yung ngayon na yung ano no, if you would have to visit the chapel of Our Lady of the Peñafrancia, just right at the back of the Basilica Minore, nandoon po nakaluklok, naka-enthrone ang original na imahe ng Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia. And this is now the image of Ina, the original image, after a series of restoration. Yung una po, if you would notice, ito yung itsura ng ina, no? Tapos ito yung ano niya, replica from the molded image of the original. Talagang buhay na buhay ang itsura niya, ano po. Pero itong original na, ito na din po siya. Pero medyo may konting ano lang dito sa ninyo dahil yung ninyo po way back then according to you know the interview which I had made sa liturgical artist that restored the image, yung kamay ng ninyo ay hindi naman po talaga nakalabas. Ngayon po, if you would notice, sa original image, nakalabas na siya. At yung lips ng blessed ninyo, nakasmile na. So parang iba na din. Ano? This happened after a series of restoration. Okay? So, at the moment, the holy devotion and story of Our Lady of Peñafrancia still attracts the countless devotees, not only from Bicol, but throughout the archipelago and of the world. Indeed, as the old adage goes, Unhain ang sarong Bicolano, yaon man si ina de Peñafrancia. Kung nasaan ang mayroong isang Bicolano, nandoon si ina de Peñafrancia. Our Lady, since then has been a protectress, I would say, even till this very moment, to all her devotees. As what the Bible reveals, that Ina shall crush the head of the serpent, the old enemy. This being the protectress is visibly shown in her ceremonial and symbolic regalia, which we will be presenting in a while. Ito po yung complete symbolic, ceremonial and symbolic regalia of Ina de Peñafrancia. And tinawag ko po siyang Ina or Ina's PPE. Bakit? I was reflecting before even the COVID-19 took place at bago pa man mauso ang PPE, no? Si Ina mayroon na po pala noon. Way in 1710, mayroon na siyang PPE. Okay? Tinawag ko po itong powerful protective equipage. Protective the Aureola de Doches Estelian. This one is a halo studded with 12 stars, no? And plated Mary in the Book of Revelation was in a woman cloth with the sun, and on her head a crown of 12 stars, which symbolizes the 12 tribes of Israel, and Mary being the queen of all the apostles. This star symbolizes also the 12 apostles of Jesus, Mary as queen of the apostles. Kaya delicate din po itong aureola. Ang iba, if you would have to try to check, ang ibang aureola, sumusubra, nagiging ng 26 or 24, 26 ang stars. Mali na sa symbolism. So isa din yan sa critical na kailangan i-consider, so to speak. No? And the second is the coronas imperiales. No? Itong coronas imperiales. The crown is actually a special honor which is being given to Mary, being our earthly mother. But at the same time, to Jesus being the king of all creation. So, you know, coronas imperiales. Also, this one will you remember on the child and the child. You will notice as if this rostrilio is very symbolic because it says that the blessed meaning or symbolism of the rostrilio shining with all the radiance on her face. Huh? And the bibero, yung bibero po, parang cloth that covers the chests of the Blessed Mother and of the Niño. And the manto de la Virgen of Peñafrancia. This is a large cape that acts as if the dress of the image, most of the time made in gold, embroidered, beaded. And you would notice itong mantupong ito ay, ito yung kulay, which is golden, yun ang kanyang original color ng kanyang manto. She's known for this. But at times, pinapalitan din po siya ng ibang liturgical colors, may white, may blue, may pink pa nga. Ganoon pong color. The manto de la Virgen. Parang kumot that really protects the image and plancha de plata. It's a large metal sheet covering the body of Ina, which serves as protection dress of the image. And the pianya. Ito pong pianya. Okay. Ito pong pianya naman is the base of Our Lady. Base where he would have to stand. And I think this symbolizes the heavenly throne of the Virgin Mary, as it is sometimes shaped like a cloud, adorned with angels. Meron po yung angel dito na nakalagay. And the Blessed Mother is being, how do you call that, known for this. Bakit po yung angel nandyan? Mary, according to the oral tradition, oral history, Mary assumed into heaven not by her own power, but Mary assumed into heaven by the power of her son, Jesus. No? Hindi yung kanyang kapangyarihan, bagkus ay kapangyarihan ng kanyang anak na si Jesus. Kaya sa utos ng kanyang anak, itinas siya sa langit kasama ng mga angeles. Now, obviously, tayo po ay nakakaranas kayo ng pandemic until this time, this very moment. And I was reflecting when I was preparing my talk in this webinar. Seeing Inha de Peñafrancia with her regalia put on, it appears to me that Inha is like a woman warrior who is always ready to fight the old enemy, the cunning serpent in the guise, in our context, no, in the guise of coronavirus. Kinilagay ko yung mga itsura dito ng coronavirus. Just like the serpent, one day, the good Lord, through Inha intercession, will crush the COVID-19. We will all be freed from fear, anxiety, and death, and decay. Now, of the regalia of Inha, Hermanto is considered as the most precious and believed to be miraculous. In fact, when the image of Inha was actually stolen in August 17, 1981, around 4:30 in the morning, it was only the manto which was left and yet was thrown like garbage in the senator grounds of Peñafrancia Shrine. But the image was not found with it. This account seemed to be as if assuring her devotees that she will surely come back, and that while she was away momentarily, her manto became a significant symbol of her loving presence as a mother to her children. A religious practice has evolved where devotees wish to be imposed with a mantle of Inha for healing with other personal petitions, an expression of steadfast trust under the protection of Inha. According po sa research, isa sa effective way of healing or recover from COVID-19, yung tinatawag po nating traditional na pagluloob ba yun? Pagsukob, no? Sa kumot, may pinakuluang mainit na tubig, doon ka, no? Mag-inhale, exhale, no? Mainit na tubig. And I was reflecting, wala siyang halos pinagkaiba dito. No? Sa manto, minan, covering us, protecting us from any danger. Kaya nga, meron ngang, because manto, the manto as one of the miraculous regalia of Inha, in an Archdiocese of Cáceres Facebook page, she was able to read isang account. Yes. Sabi niya dito, if I may read, Monsignor Alfredo Eliana kindly gave a blue cape of the Blessed Virgin to my parents, who placed it under my pillow while I was operated on at the Philippine General Hospital. My mom and dad prayed long and hard for the help of Inha while the operation was going on. Alas, and behold, I was voraciously sucking milk from a mother's breast immediately after the operation and released in the hospital in just a week. So in other words, friends, ito po yung isa lamang sa mga many accounts na nagpapatotoo that Ina, most especially Hermanto, has a miraculous effect or healing to the ones who believe. Okay? So, ito po yung mga kung wala pang COVID, this was I think taken way back in 2019, 2018 po ito, nagpapa-impose ang mga devotees sa manto ni Ina, believing that Ina will really heal them and listen to their cries. Ito po yung, if you would have to visit the Our Lady of Peñafrancia Museum, no? Just nearby the shrine of Ina. During the historic canonical coronation in September 20, 1924. So preserved pa po siya until now since 1924. This one is the manto naman po of Ina ripped off during the unruly traslacion procession in September 1996. Makita nyo, no? Ang manto niya dito ay gutay-gutay, no? Kasi yung mga how do you call it, yung mga Voyadores ay very unruly accordingly. And so, ayun ang nangyari sa kanyang manto, no? In fact, there was an account pa na nahubaran ang mahal na birhen, no? Sa in the midst of the unruly procession, nahubaran siya, and there was this priest got up and put on the manto of Ina. Ito, na supposed to be itong mga Voyadores ay the ones to protect the image, because way back then, no, when Father Covarrubias requested the local artisan to carve the image and entrusted the image to the Cimarrones, the first and original Bugadores or Voyadores, Voyadores, who were the Cimarrones then that protects the image of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And this, at this point, this leads me to a further sharing on you on about the Voyadores of Ina de Peñafrancia. And I'd like to share this with you, that Peñafrancia then, or Peñafrancia celebration and fluvial procession. This is a triumphant waterborne Catholic procession carrying a statue of the Virgin Mary, which is the Naga City's number one attraction. Since 1885, the traditional traslacion and fluvial procession became the way of life of every Bicolano. And when the month of September comes, Bicolano's spirit is once more awakened to commit to a noble celebration of Peñafrancia Fiesta. Notwithstanding the distances and high cost of transportation, the rich, the poor, the old, the young, and even the sick will trek to Naga on that memorable fiesta. The Peñafrancia Fiesta is considered a phenomenal spectacle wherein the Voyadores played the major role to protect the image of Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia. Seemingly, yung picture nakita niyo seem to be to oppose the reality, no? Anyway, the Voyadores are the paddlers who tow the Virgin's pagoda. They also serve as cordon to the holy image of Ina. And yet, Peñafrancia Fiesta is the most anticipated feast in the whole Bicol region. However, like any recent event. Kaya sabi ni Luis General Tal, the genuineness of the Bicolanos' faith to Mary may be doubted by the tourist or stranger as he watches a Peñafrancia procession, for he sees only the apparent fanatical emotionalism. So yun yun. And as you can see sa picture, sa photos, no? Ito po yung itsura ng mga boyador as supposed to protect the image. Try to examine this photo, which was taken from Translation of Our Lady of Peñafrancia in 1949. Simple andas lang ang lalagyan ng ating mahal na birin compared doon sa ngayon, ito na yung andas ni Ina, naging na siyang dome after series of formation and information. Okay? So, makita niyo po, no, the boyadores, seemingly, you would have to wonder, anong rason bakit siya aakyat? Ano ba yan? Just to show off? Para ganitong pangyayari, would have to assume that this is purely fanaticism. Where in fact, this is not fanaticism. Okay? Kaya nagtanong ako, sabi ko, ang buyador ba ay isang devotee or devote? Yung devote, ano po? Siya ba isang devotee or devote? As if you try to, ano po, ano? Try to, how do you call this? Get into the midst of this unruly buyadores. Kahit nga sa malayo, talagang aboy na aboy mo ang liquor, ang alak. Sabi ko, Diyos ko, makikita mo along the way while waiting for Ina to comes the buyadores would have to take not only sip but talagang halos ubusin ang bote ng how do you call it, ang alak. Kaya sabi ko, mga devotees ba ito? Devotees. So that's the thing. And this one prompted me really to conduct a research way back then. Kasi talagang naano ako, no? And we would have to hear some comments from a tourist, comments from our other faith, tingnan nyo na ang mga Katoliko, et cetera, et cetera. So this prompted me to really conduct research, no? And I was able to have at least 20 key informants in this case, from different walks of life. My pare, my ordinary vendor, my may isang ama, isang security guard, and the rest. So I began, you know, coming up with a case studies and case analysis in this case. So I'd like to share with you the findings of my research. First, the 20 key informants are within the age range of 25 to 65. 45% comprise the ages of ranges 25 to 35, which fall under early adulthood years. Hence, I would say that key informants were more physical, whose endurance last until they have had brought enough to her destination. Of 20 key informants, 30% of them were college graduates. This majority of them are educable and capable of learning. As far as my key informants are concerned, there was a majority number of key early adulthood. This indicates that majority of them were more active and dynamic. In fact, of the range 5 to 48, 55% of the range 5 to 15 got its highest percent. The key informants were classified such as white-collared workers, blue-collared workers, clergymen, religious brothers, and non-specified job individuals. In each occupation, 4 key informants were drawn, which gave with a total of 20 key informants. it was found out that the most prevailing reason of the Voyadores in joining the traslacion and fluvial processions was panata, panata, a solemn pledge. It was 60% of the total enumeration of the key informants' reason in joining the procession. There were voyadores in their enthusiasm to voya would result on having blisters, wounds, and fights with the fellow voyadores. One of the key informants was accused as the one who initiated the rumble in the midst of the procession, which brought him to prison. And on the other hand, one of the key informants was able to experience divine intervention when once he joined the voya. He was in an instant cured of his sickness, according to him. Apparent rudeness in the traslacion and fluvial processions were brought by the drunken voyadores. Would become drunk. So unfortunate. Thus could no longer function as voyadores of ina. Kaya makikita mo, habang daladala nila ang mahal na birhen, pati yung mahal na birhen ay parang lasing na rin, no? Atrasabante ba? No? So color coding scheme which was provided by the church among the voyadores was found defective by the voyadores themselves. It caused much trouble and adds more anxiety among voyadores, but it lacks spiritual transcendence. Thus, the practices of the voyadores may result to a crucible fanaticism. And so, my study concluded that most of the voyadores were in the early adulthood. Majority of them were college graduate. As to the number of years as voyadores, most of them fall under the range of 5 to 15 years of commitment. They were classified such as white-collared workers, blue-collared workers, clergy, religious brothers, and no specified job individuals. And so again, as I mentioned, panata was the most prevailing reason why they do have to join in the traditional traslacion and fluvial processions. They have different experiences and practices. And with all these experiences, case analysis, etc., case digesting all these reasons, I was able to propose a program. And back then, the late Archbishop Legazpi was actually then alive. And one of our DC sister gave him a copy of my research. So what was my recommendations? There must be a thorough profiling and organizational structure of the voyadores. Selling and buying of liquor may be prohibited a week before the Peñafrancia festivities. The Department of Education and the CHED must integrate local history in the curriculum. Religious educators and social science teachers should give emphasis on the teaching about the historical as well as doctrinal implications of fiesta celebration. Likewise, they must emphasize personal discipline and correct outlook on the celebration of fiesta. The government must be assertive in helping the Church of Cáceres and providing the needs of the voyadores like ambulances and enough water pumps or portable water aid. The Philippine National Police should also attend seminar to better their understanding about Peñafrancia celebration and the voyadores. The Church of Cáceres should be constant in imposing discipline among voyadores. Director of the Basilica may come up with a formal filing of the profile and structure confederation. So at the moment, ito na po yung ating voyadores ngayon. So far, well-organized na. No? And mayroon ng color coding na maayos, and even the police actually participated in the said grand procession of the Blessed Mother and of the Divino Host. There are also notable personalities that joined the grand processions, like in the case of the late Mayor Jesse Robredo, who've been our DILG secretary. He's actually a Voyador of Ina de Peñafrancia. Makita niyo ang kanyang hindi lang sabi ko, hindi lang pala siya sa chinelas leadership. No? Kahit nakapaa leadership, andun siya. No? Anda siya. No? To really mingle with ordinary and common people. And of course, his wife, our very own Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, also a devotee of our Blessed Mother. And some other characters have to come to be the grand celebration of Ina de Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia. Friends, our devotion to Ina, I would say, is never complete unless it leads us to her son, Jesus. We have the Blessed Mother, we have the Ina, but it would be complete, it would be incomplete unless it leads us to her son, Jesus. And so allow me to give you just a glimpse, no, of one beautiful devotion to Divino Rostro. Just a glimpse. I would not discuss the history of the Divino Rostro, because it might again eat a lot more of time. No? It was just given like 1 to 1.5 hours, because this is a Zoom webinar. So who knows, baka in the future, may invite naman ako ng National Historical Commission of the Philippines to talk about the Divino Rostro. But I can't help but still push through this, a little glimpse of the devotion to the Divino Rostro. Nakita niyo sa left side, ito po yung imahe o canvas ng Divino Rostro in Spain, also de la Viga, Spain in 1834. Ito naman po yung atin, no? Sa right dito. Pero this is not the original image. Later siguro makikita niyo po yung original na kuha na ng photo. And okay naman yung itsura niya, halos nag-jive doon sa original. Kasi at times po, ang ibang artist na susubrahan yung kanilang pagguhit ng larawan ni Divino Rostro, medyo na ano yung naibang itsura, no? Just a glimpse of the division, a devotion to the Divino Rostro. In Spain, in the year 1834 to 1865, there was this cholera morbo which broke in Spain, and many of its towns suffered from the remorseful effects of the dreadful malady. Through a special flux of divine providence, however, attributed only to special devotion of the people to the Divino Rostro, Osa de la Vega did not witness of demise of even one of its inhabitants. So napaka-miraculous yung nangyari sa kanila. Sila lang. Ang Osa de la Vega was faithful then to the divine face of Jesus, the Divino Rostro, has been spared from this cholera morbo. In the year 1882, a cholera morbo broke out in Manila. Same pandemic. No? And it broke out in Manila, so a cure for the disease was not yet discovered. So many died of the disease. Rapidly, the dreadful disease reached Nueva Cáceres, now Naga City, in 1882. Nalala ko yung COVID-19 ngayon. So Bishop Casimero Herrera, with his priests then, made a promise. No? Kaya kung kay Ina ang tawag ay panata, ito naman po ay panuga. Ang tawag naman, panuga kay Divino Rostro or promise. should the dreadful disease spare Naga, the Divino Rostro will be pompously venerated with its special festivities together with the Virgin of Peñafrancia within 3 days. And accordingly, the dreadful disease disappeared. The people saw the hand of God in this miraculous saving of the town and made good their promise. When the image of Our Lady of Peñafrancia was to be taken to the cathedral from the shrine, as promised, on September of that year in 1883, the Divino Rostro was also carried along the procession. Kaya since 1883 po, magkasama na yung mag-ina sa traslasyon procession and at the same time sa fluvial procession. Indeed, I would say now that we are experiencing COVID-19, this pandemic, I would say that we have no reason to be afraid and be anxious in these trying times. Because in the midst of this pandemic, where we are all in, because we have with us right on our side, our two powerful, miraculous healing icons, which seem telling the resounding verse in the Bible, seeing them, do not be afraid. Naalala ko yung in Exodus 15, verse 26. God that healeth thee, I am the Lord, your healer. Do not be afraid. At this point, my friends, I'm almost ending, but before we have to end, I'd like to invite you just the same to join me again in praying the prayer to the Divino Rostro. O Jesus, in your bitter passion, you became a man of sorrows. In your disfigured face, I see your infinite love. I am consumed with a desire to love you and make you loved by all. I venerate your sacred face because it is the human expression of the face of the Father. The tears on your eyes are the pearls which I desire to offer to God in expiation for my sins and the spiritual salvation of sinners. O Jesus, your adorable face ravishes my heart, gazes into my eyes, and touch my heart, and set me on fire with your love, so that my only desire will be to contemplate your glorious face in heaven. Amen. Let me end my sharing today with the borrowed words from St. John Paul II during his papal visit to the Philippines, particularly when he came to Bicol in February 21, 1981, and I quote, "And may Our Lady of Peñafrancia continue to love you, console you, protect you and your families, in your country. Amen." So, I personally wish to express my gratitude to you all for attending in this webinar. God bless you all through the intercession of Ina, Our Lady of Peñafrancia. Viva la Virgen! Viva el Divino Rostro! Thank you.
Marami pong salamat, Dr. Cesar San Jose, sa pagbabahagi ng iyong kaalaman and expertise sa ating paksa na pinamagatang Ina Peñafrancia, The Voyadores Journey with the Grand Patroness of Bicolandia. Marami po kaming natutunan sa inyong webinar, and then as inagenyo din na yearly nag-attend ng Peñafrancia, medyo malungkot ngayong taon na wala yung mga magarbo at festive na celebration of the Peñafrancia Festival. Kasi normally, buong September, maingay ang buong Naga City when it comes to the Peñafrancia Festival. Medyo sad, pero we power through, and sabi nga po ni Archbishop, the Peñafrancia will always be in our hearts. Maski nasa ibang bansa ka, maski nasa Manila ka, maski hindi ka nakauwi. Kahit hindi ka nakauwi, kahit saan panig ka man ng mundo, Peñafrancia will always, Our Lady of Peñafrancia will always be there for us. Ayan, bilang parte ng ating programa sa araw na ito, meron tayong mga napiling katanungan para sa ating tagapagsalita. First question, sir, from Mr. Francis Razon. How to become a true Voyadores?
How to become a true Voyadores? Ano? Nako, medyo personal, ano? Actually, way back then, ano, as we have been mentioning doon sa history, the Cimarrones were actually the original Voyadores of Ina, the Nuestra Señora de Peñafrancia. Ang mga Cimarrones po yung mga Aitas that time, the native Aitas way back then in Isarog, no? Sa, medyo sa ano ng Isarog. Sila po yun, mga Cimarrones. And in fact, so much of their desire to love the Blessed Virgin Mary, sila po yung nagkusang mag-request kay Father Miguel Robles de Cabarrubias na malagyan sila ng chapel nearby their native land. Yun yung ngayong Peña de Francia, shrine of the Peña de Francia. Yan yung original home ng ina. So, yung Voyadores o Cimarrones, yung nag-first move, though, nag-jibe doon sa intention ni Father Miguel. Sa promise niya, di ba? Na magtatayo siya in honor as a thanksgiving at the same time of ina. Vision niya na yun eh. Magtatayo siya ng isang kapilya. Nag-jibe doon sa mga desire din ng Cimarrones. But what I want you to look into, yung desire ng Cimarrones na makapiling ang isang ina. So in other words, kung isa kang debutante, deboto, isa kang Voyador, ikaw yung parating mag-first move na in mind, in heart, and in spirit, most especially in action, makikita yung ano nga ba ang pagiging Voyador. Sabi nga doon sa presentation ko sa inyo, you must at all costs protect the Blessed Mother, and that one becomes the authentic sign of becoming true and genuine Voyador o Voyadores of Ina de Peñafrancia. Yun yun. No? Yung genuineness. Hindi mo kailangan maglasing para masabing isa ka ng totoo at ganap na Voyador. Hindi pwede. Kasi ang nagmamahal sa isang ina de Peña de Francia ay isang masunurin and at the same time well-behaved. That's observing the proper decorum in liturgical, most especially liturgical celebration. I hope I was able to answer that.
Yes, sir. Another question po, sir, from Miss Melinda Celoso. How did the devotion to Peñafrancia influence the Bicolano culture as a whole po, si Bicolandia?
Come again po?
How did the devotion to Peñafrancia influence the Bicolano culture?
Okay, so how did? Pag sinabi kasing Bicolano, nasa tatak Bicolano yung sinasabing pagiging Marian devotee. At makikita nyo ang isang depiction ng isang Marian kahit saan. No? Kaya nga sabi niyan, ang celebration ng translasyon at lubial procession ay hindi lang po nagaganap dito within the Naga City, hindi po. All throughout the Archdiocese of Cáceres and even beyond archdiocese, within even Bicol or even outside Bicol. No? And yung pagiging Marian ay nasa kultura na ng isang Bicolano. Na pag sinabing Bicolano, hindi yung common na sinasabi sa atin, Uragon. No? Hindi po. Hindi lang yan. Pag sinabing Bicolano, isa siyang deboto ni Ina di Peñafrancia. At all costs. No? Para bang pag lumalabas ang isang Voyador, no? Para siyang nakikita ko sa niya parang isang knight, no? Isang papal knight at that, no? Na at all costs ibubuhis niya, no? Ang kanyang buhay just to protect the lady. And nakapasok na po yan sa kultura ng bawat Bicolano or bawat Pilipino. Kaya nga kung mayroong Bicolano sa abroad, makikita mo like sometime I think that was last year sa Canada, no? Nagkaroon din sila ng sarili nilang translasyon, no? No? Nauuna pa kapag pumasok ang Setyembre, nauuna pa tayo kay Jose Marichan. Okay? Pag sinabi ng Setyembre, di Peñafrancia. At nasa kaisipan na yan ng bawat Bicolano. At ramdam na natin yan. At dito sa Naga City, makikita mo na yung banderitas, yung mga et cetera na colorful and all, na talagang feel na feel mo ang festivities. Na indeed, fiesta ito, fiesta. At ito ay kaarawan ng dakilang ina di Peñafrancia. At nakakalimutan yung mga awayan, bangayan, etc. Dahil fiesta, mga ganun, kultura na ng Pilipin. Yung sharing nandoon, pag may umusok ng isang ano dyan, naku, nandyan, mag-flock ang mga friends, kahit hindi friends. No? Talaga mag-flock at makikipag-fiesta, kainan, something like that. It's a celebration, really, because it's the great day of Ina de Peñafrancia. And it becomes a culture, no? Of all Bicolano. Natutuwa nga ako sa Libmanan. Ano? Sa Libmanan, yung dahil bawal ngayon ang you know, social distancing, all COVID-19 tayo, pandemic ba? Sa Libmanan, meron tinatawag sila, kung sa ating translation, sa kanila, bisiklasyon. Sabi ko, bakit bisiklasyon? Yung pala, no, yung mga devotee ay nakabisikleta. Ganun, ano? Sabi ko, saludo ako kay Bishop Rojas. Ang galing ng kay devoto, no, kay ina at sina ina sa pick up, no, pinagpo-prosesyon accordingly. So I think nasagot ko yung tanong na.
Yes, well. Another question po from Mr. Dennis Castanos, where did the Divino Rostro came from? Was it brought by the Spaniards along with the image of ina or discovered as an artifact in Naga City po?
As how do you call that? As mentioned po baga ano yung same with how do you call that history, same with the history of ina, etong kay Divino Rostro ay sasagutin natin yan para may suspense. Just in case, next time around, that we got the webinar on the Divino Rostro. Pero, one good thing, ipinasok ko kasi ang Divino Rostro kasi sabi ko nga, hindi kumpleto ang devotion kay Ina kung wala ang Divino Rostro. Kasi yun ang pinaka-ultimate goal. Eh. Ad Jesum per Maria. To Jesus through Mary. So, isa lamang instrumento ang mahal na Ina Birhen di Peñafrancia, papunta kay Divino Rostro ang maluwalhating mukha ng Ama. No? So yun yun. Ang history po ng Peñafrancia ay same with El Divino Rostro. Dinala din siya dito sa atin. At na, kung ang Peñafrancia ay mayroong tinatawag na panata, ito naman kay Divino Rostro, may panoga. Kasi nagkaroon that time ng tinatawag na cholera morbo na nakarating from Manila, nakarating dito sa Naga. So ito si Bishop Casimero Herrera ay how do you call that? nag-ano siya, nag-promise sila ayon sa mga kaparian na kapag nawala, no, in an instant, no, it takes 3 days, I think, according to history, 3 days. Yung una, mayroong parang namatay na tatlo. Second day, I think dalawang namatay dito sa Naga. On the third day, wala, totally zero namatay because of cholera morbo. And that actually was the response of the blessedness of Divino Rostro. Kaya doon, nanuga, nagpanuga, nagpromise sila with Bishop Casimero Herrera na ipuprosesyon ang imahe ng Divino Rostro together with Ina de Peñafrancia way back din in 1883. And isang pare ang nag-donate din yon, same with the image of the Peñafrancia, at inilukluk na ang isang canvas na ito, isang imaheng ito, isang icon na ito sa Peña de Francia Shrine, and na ngayon ay nasa Basilica Minore na po siya. Medyo fragile na siya eh. 1883 eh. Pag nakita mo yung kanyang original image, kahit ang isang liturgical artist, magdadalawang isip na i-restore siya pa unti-unti kasi napaka-fragile na ng kanyang, ano, kanyang item, kanyang, how do you call that, canvas. Canvas kasi siya eh. So, ganun po siya. Siguro, next time around, when the National Historical Commission of the Philippines would invite me again, I will be telling you about stories and histories on the Divino Rostro. Ang importante, ngayon, in the midst of pandemic, may dalawa tayong miraculous icons on our side telling us, don't be afraid, life must go on, we are with you. Parang ganun, ano po. Thank you so much.
Last question, sir, from Mr. Roman Morales. Meron po bang naitalang accidental deaths during the translation or fluvial procession?
So far po, ano, as far as some records are concerned, so far wala naman po. Pero may mga, ano, may mga nasusugatan, mayroong nag-hyperventilate, parang gano'n, mayroong na-dismaya, mga gano'n. Mga ganoon lang. Pero as to the death sa translation at fluvial, wala naman. Pero there was this history way back then. I think that was 1972, if I'm not mistaken. Nagkaroon ng yung insidente sa yung collapse ng Colgante. At marami talaga doon na namatay. Marami, hundreds of them died. And that was the prelude before, accordingly nga, pinag-aaralan ng mga historical analyst and some, ano, baka para siyang prelude na, remember that time that happened, that incident happened prior to the declaration of Marisol. Okay, parang gano'n. That was that year. No? Tapos that time also, naging unruly ang mga Voyadores, very ano sila, unruly. Sabi nila, parang may kakaibang nangyayari. And sabi ng mga matatanda that time, sa Little Stories of the Devotion, sabi nila, that bago naganap ang Colgante accident or incident na yon, ay naging pula ang sky. Kulay-pula daw. So parang may mga premonitions or something, you know, telling us that these things will happen. Yun lang, so far ang naitala, na grabe talagang namatay that time. Pauwi na noon si Ina, fluvial procession na po yun. And immediately after, nakakross na yung pagoda ni Ina during the fluvial procession, nag-collapse bigla yung bridge. Made of wood pa yun eh, that time. It collapsed and many really had died in that instance. So yun, so far yun lang po. Pero as at the moment, ngayon halos salamat sa Diyos, wala man namamatay o na aksidente, etc. sa anong ito, sa procession. Salamat.
So yun, sir, thank you so much, Dr. Cesar.
Thank you, again, thank you also.
For this very meaningful lecture for us all Bicolanos. Ayan, bilang parte ng ating programa, bago magtapos ang ating programa, nais po namin pasalamatan ang mga sumusunod. Unang-una po si Dr. Cesar San Jose, ang Dean of the Universidad de Santa Isabel Graduate School for this lecture. To the Universidad de Santa Isabel, sa ating mga participants ngayong hapon, maraming salamat po. To the National Historical Commission of the Philippines, to the Historic Sites and Education Division, the Ilocos Norte, Naga, Visayas, Mindanao Cluster, especially the Museo ni Sa Rizal Dapitan, the Museo ng Kasaysayang Buholano, the Museo ni Na Juan at Antonio Luna, at Museo ng Kasaysayang Pang-ekonomiya ng Pilipinas. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Para naman sa ating mga manonood na nais makatanggap ng Certificate of Participation, may link po na ipopost sa ating comment section. Maaari pong i-click ito at sagutan ng ating evaluation. Ito ay matatanggap nyo sa loob ng 5 araw sa inyong mga email accounts. Marami pong salamat at panatilihin po nating ligtas ang bawat isa. Thank you po.